My dear students, today we are going to study bead design factors. So let us start. So bead are of two types. One is rolling cone bead, in which the cones rotate, and there is another type of bead, that is polycrystalline diamond bead, or in short PDC bead. In PDC bead there is moving parts, but in roller cone beads the rollers are moving parts. Now rolling cone bead can be of three types: two cone roller bead, three cone roller bead, and four cone roller bead. Two cone roller bead is also called a bicone roller bead. Three cone roller bead is also called tricone roller bead, and in fact this is the most widely used drilling bead in industry. Four cone roller bead, these are also called quad cone roller bead, and these are occasionally used for very large diameter of wellbore. Wellbores in which the diameter exceeds 26 inch. This is a picture of a bicone bead, of a tricone roller bead. These three are the cones for a quad cone roller bead. Now coming to the bead design factor, we have five factors, that is journal angle, cone offset or skew angle, teeth, bearing assembly, lubrication system, and along with that bead nozzle and its angle of orientation is to some extent important. Now let us start with journal angle. Journal is this metal shaft on which your cone will be mounted. This is a cylindrical metal shaft and your cone will be mounted in this shaft. Now journal angle is the angle subtended by the line perpendicular to the journal and the bead axis. So this is your journal angle. Now for 0° journal angle, as the bottom part of any cone should be horizontal, so for a 0° journal angle a cone is not possible. As you can see here, only a cylinder is possible. On rotation this cylinder will roll. When it rolls it has a tendency to follow a straight path. This dotted line shows the path it has a tendency to follow. But since it is attached to the bead, so instead the cylinder will be dragged to follow a circular path. So here we can say that there is no rolling friction in this 0° journal angle bead. Whereas in 15° case, we can see that cone will have a tendency to roll and it will follow a circular path only. This dotted line will be a circular path, but since it is attached to the bit, so it will be dragged, and this circular part will be larger than this well bore. So there will be some degree of freedom, as this path traced by the cone is also circular, but it will be to some extent dragged. Now coming to the case of a 45° cone, we will get a perfect cone, and this cone has a tendency to roll around its apex. Since the apex of the cone and the bit axis coincide, so it is freely rolling as the bit rotates. So this is a true rolling cone bit. In practice, a true rolling cone bit does not work very well. The teeth only hit and fracture the rock, but there is no dragging action, so the fractured chips doesn't come out. After repeated hitting, there will be chips accumulated at the bottom of the wellbore, and hence the efficiency will decrease. To carry out chips, dragging is very much necessary. The volume of the metal of the cone increases as the journal angle decreases below 45°. And it is important because we put several tons of weight on the bit. The more metallic volume it has, the more it can withstand the weight and put our weight on bit. And it is magnified by the fact this cone is hollow. We need to have some space for putting it inside the journal. We have to put our weight on. Moreover, we should have such a journal angle that it will provide sufficient drag. So from Over the years, it has been observed that the optimum journal angle is 33 to 36 degrees, which provides the best combination for wear and tear, drag, and the strength of the cone. Now, if we put a larger bearing here, if we put a larger contact here, then we have to compromise with by a small journal, because in between the journal and the cone there will be some bearings. So if the bearing thickness is more, then the journal thickness will reduce. Coming to the second factor, that is skew angle. Skew angle is the distance between the bit axis and the journal axis. This is the small distance between the bit axis. This point here denotes the bit axis, and in a horizontal plane this is the journal axis. So the small distance between this is called the offset, and this angle between the journal axis and line connecting bit center is the skew angle. We need this to provide additional drag, and this additional drag will push the materials to the periphery of the bit, and as such the bottom hole cleaning increases. As a result, our drilling efficiency also increases. For soft formation, we keep large offset, and for hard brittle rock we need no offset. For medium hard rock we need offset up to 2 degrees. Teeth, there are three factors. First is spacing and interfitting, second is shape and length, and third is type of teeth. For soft formation, the materials cut will be more, as such we need more space so that the materials can come out of the well bore. For hard formation, the cutting will be less, generated will be less, as such small spacing between the teeth will also help. The teeth of the cones are interfitting. You can see the this teeth is interfitting with the nearby cone. Why? Because this interfitting helps in self cleaning of the bit. It prevents sticking of the cutting between the teeth and becomes self cleaning. As per shape and length is concerned, for soft formation we need sharp and longer teeth. Why? Because for soft formation we can penetrate with the longer teeth, and it can dig out the materials beneath it. But in case of hard formation, this longer teeth might break. As a result, we opt for blunt and shorter teeth so that teeth breaking is reduced and our drilling efficiency is also not hampered. You can see from this diagram, for soft formation you can means the length of the teeth is more, and for hard formation you can see there are blunt teeth with short length. Type of teeth. For soft formation we use mill teeth. Mill teeth are cut from the cone body. Since it is milled from the same material, it is not hard enough. So a layer of tungsten carbide is used to cover the body so that it becomes to some extent hard enough, and tungsten carbide is the second hardest material. First is obviously diamond. For hard formation we use insert teeth. These insert teeth are actually inserted into the holes for the teeth, and these are made up of tungsten carbide. Remember, this insert teeth is made tungsten carbide, whereas in mill teeth it is made up of the metal as the bit body but has a layer of tungsten carbide. Here in mill teeth there is a layer of tungsten carbide, whereas the insert teeth hole is made up of tungsten carbide. Fourth is the bearing assembly. We have three number of bearing. In some larger bit there are even four number of bearing. The bearing near to this cone is nose bearing, next is the ball bearing, and third is the journal bearing or inner bearing. Now if the bearing wears out, then we have to change the bit, and if that wears out, then also we have to change the bit. So the bearing is made in such a way that it wears out along with the teeth. Now it has to support the radial load due to weight on bit, and it has to support thrust load due to rotation, and also it has to secure the cone to the body. This is done by the ball bearing. There will be a groove in this cone which will fit to this ball bearing assembly. As such, hold the cone in the journal. Now this is how a ball bearing looks. The other is this roller bearings. Roller means those will have small rollers to reduce the friction between them. Bearing assembly are of two types. One is anti-friction bearing, another is friction bearing. Anti-friction bearing is again of two types. The arrangement is roller, ball and roller. The nose bearing will be a roller bearing, intermediate will be a ball bearing, and the outer or journal bearing will also be a roller bearing. So this will have a very short life and normally used with bit diameter greater than 12 1/4 inch with adequate space so that it can fit the roller bearings inside it. Type we have another type of bearing, that is roller, ball and friction. Friction type bearing will be at the nose. This friction bearing will not have rollers, that will have two inlays, a hard metal inlay and a soft, that will reduce the friction between them and will allow rotation also. The intermediate will be a ball bearing and the journal bearing will be a roller bearing again. So this allow a thicker cone section because the rollers won't be there at the nose bearing. As such, you will have a metal near the nose bearing. It is common for bit sizes up to 12 1/4 inch. And there is another type of is bearing arrangement, that is for friction bearing, that is friction ball and friction. Is the nose bearing will have a friction bearing, intermediate will be a ball bearing, and journal bearing will be a friction bearing. Here it allows even thicker cones than the roller ball and friction bearing. So here in this diagram you can see, this is the nose bearing, this is the ball bearing or intermediate bearing, and this is the journal bearing. In the first arrangement you will have rollers here, roller bearing here, you will have roller bearing here, and this will be a ball bearing. In the second, roller, ball and friction, we will have a roller bearing, here we will have ball bearing, and here we will have a friction bearing. In the friction bearing arrangement, we will have a friction bearing here, we will have a friction bearing here, and a ball bearing in the intermediate section. Now let's come to the lubrication system. Now the lubrication system are of two types. One is sealed, another is non-sealed. Now in non-sealed, it is lubricated by the mud itself, but in sealed, it will be lubricated by the inbuilt lubrication system. But lubrication by mud is generally recommended. Seal bearing consists of a bearings, seal, reservoir and pressure compensator. Pressure diaphragm will be operated by mud pressure. Mud puts pressure on it. It will release some lubricant from a lubricant reservoir and it will lubricate the bearings. Bit nozzle and its angle. So for PDC bit there may be a different arrangement, but for rolling cone bit there is only one arrangement, that is it will have nozzles between the legs. Now angle of orientation is very important because different angle creates different flow patterns, but then this is purely dependent on the manufacturer on how they will create the shape of the nozzle. And these nozzles will be screwed at nozzle slots and it will allow the drilling fluid to pass through it at a very high speed. So thank you.